Hi, if it's your first time here, welcome to our channel. My name is Julian, this is Dimitri.
Hello everyone.
We're talking about fragrances here, and if you enjoy this topic, we'll be more than happy if you subscribe to our channel. Today we'll review a fragrance by niche fragrance house, MDCI, and the fragrance is called Chypre Palatin.
I love this fragrance so much. It's one of my absolute favorite fragrances in my collection, and overall, from every fragrance that I have smelled in my life, I think it's an absolute masterpiece by the master perfumer Bertrand Duchaufour. It was released in 2012, if I remember correctly, and it's a Chypre oriental fragrance. I will show you the presentation quickly and then we'll continue.
The presentation is quite simple here. We've got a cardboard box, but I have to say that the bottle itself looks amazing. Like, I really love the simplicity and the look of it. It looks nice. I mean, there's nothing too much extra. They've got the other ones with the bust, but it's not really that necessary here, to be honest. And the tassel looks really nice as well.
Actually, I love this bottle presentation. I have another one fragrance from MDCI. It's called Ambre Top Capi. It's with a resin bust. Very beautiful, this white bust. Looks stunning, but very pricey. It costs 125 euros only for the bust. And the price of this fragrance is 225 euros for 75 ml in this presentation. And I bought it 1.5 years ago, in autumn 2021, for 160 euros. It was on a discount, and I blind bought it, and it was the best blind buy in that year, in 2021, along with the Riche Le Dorais Classic Collection, which contains Oud Zen, Russian Musk 2, and Ottoman Empire 3. Those were also an amazing blind buy. About this fragrance. So, it's like a life in a bottle. It's just stunning. It's very elegant, very classy. It smells very refined, blended to perfection. It's my favorite Bertrand Duchaufour fragrance, along with Jubilation 25 for Men from Amouage. That one is also a masterpiece.
And also Fusion Secret Obscure is by him as well?
Yes.
Yes.
Amazing. We also really love Fusion Secret Obscure.
Actually, we had the top three Bertrand Duchaufour fragrances, and all of these three fragrances were in that list. And guys, these are some of the best fragrances that are out there, in my opinion. All right, are you going to spray it again?
Yeah, I'll spray it again for you. I have sprayed it already 25 minutes ago. Some are here. Sprayer is very, very nice. Sprays very wide. The opening is so alive and so sparkling, so beautiful. It has a lot of aldehydes in the opening. It's very fizzy. I can feel these bubbles coming to my nose. It's a very happy opening, and it also has quite a lot of this mandarin clementine smell in the opening. Fruity, very very juicy, very juicy opening. It also has galbanum, which gives this fragrance this green aspect, green vibe. It also has a lot of aromatic notes, like herbs, like sage, lavender, hyacinth. I think it's absolute perfection. It's like a 3D fragrance, yeah? It's very full, very alive, very bright. In the heart notes, then it develops. It's changing a lot. And every time I spray it, every time I smell it, I pick some different notes from this fragrance.
That's true. Yeah.
It's so complex, unbelievable. I get this beautiful plum vibe from it. The fruitiness is amazing here, yeah? And you can really feel the beautiful fruity aspect of this fragrance. In the heart, it also has a lot of floral notes like rose, jasmine, iris, gardenia. I can't pick any separate floral note from this fragrance, but I can feel this beautiful floral bouquet.
I really am.
It's not very floral, but it's mixed very beautifully into this composition.
That's true. It's this fragrance is blended to a perfection, and here sometimes it's hard to actually say what exactly are you smelling, but although sometimes you're just getting a whiff and it's like a whole composition, and the other time you sniff it and then you get a note that you can actually describe. It's a playful composition, it's a live composition, and it's really interesting. And I have to say from my side that I enjoy this a lot, and I know that a lot of men enjoy this fragrance, and I have to say that it's a totally unisex fragrance, and if you're a female, I'm pretty sure that you might like it as well. And to me, it's like my favorite Chypre, I think, at the moment.
Really, it's really definitely it. One of my favorite Chypre fragrances. Someday we'll do our top favorite Chypres. Yeah, and this will be very high on the list. We just unboxed today Diaghilev by Roger Parfums. It's on our hands now, and I must say that Diaghilev is an amazing Chypre. Mm-hmm. Amazing, truly beautiful and very complex. I love them both. I don't know which one I prefer more. For now, I think they both are exquisite fragrances, both masterpieces. And Chypre Palatin, for the price, is better.
Yes, yeah. Plus I also think that this is not an ordinary Chypre. It's got this oriental vibe, and it's got this balsamic notes and some vanilla, and it makes this fragrance so cozy and appealing at the same time. The mix of the notes is so exquisite here and smells unique. That's why I really, really enjoy this fragrance. And to be honest, yes, as for a female, this kind of note blending, to me, it's perfect, because I get everything that I want in a fragrance here.
Yeah.
It's a little bit sweet. It's got some fruity notes. It's got some woody notes. It's balsamic. It's got some oak moss. I mean, just everything that you would want in a fragrance, it's got like every bit of aspect to my nose. I think that it's a complex, and maybe if you had a choice to have only one fragrance in your collection, that could be this fragrance, I think.
I think it's definitely signature scent worthy. From all of my fragrances, when I open my closet, yeah, I always want to sniff Chypre Palatin because I love it so much. And every time I smell it from the bottle, from the cap, from here, I just want to spray it every time. I want to wear it in the morning, in the evening, at night. I want to wear it on Monday, on Sunday, every day. It's just that good. I want to wear it in winter. I want to wear it in the summer. I want to wear it in every season, in every possible weather, in every occasion.
Yes, it's very, very versatile.
But I think for many people it would be like a more festive fragrance, for maybe more for a special occasion. You have to be maybe a little bit dressed up for this type of composition, yeah? And for the notes, I also get quite a lot of labdanum in here. It has a very resinous base, so the opening is very bright. It reminds me of a beautiful proper Chypre in the opening, but it dries down to this beautiful oriental balsamic vanillic fragrance. It's just amazing. It has in the base notes, it has a lot of oak moss. Yeah, it has a castoreum, which gives this a touch of animalics. By the way, this animalics is very, very elegant, and it gives this kind of wow effect to this composition. I guess all this animalic notes and oak moss. Yeah, it also has a lot of tolu balsam, very, very huge amount of tolu balsam in the base. It also has a lot of vanilla, immortelle, benzoin. It has leather, styrax. So there are a lot of balsamic notes in this base of the composition.
So I can quickly just read you from the MDCI website, the notes. So they say that main olfactic notes are hyacinth, tangerine, cistus, galbanum, thyme, lavender in the head notes. Heart notes are rose, jasmine, iris, prune, gardenia. And in the base notes, there are benzoin, styrax, castoreum, leathers, tolu, vanilla, everlasting, absolute, oak foam. So very complex and interesting mix. And actually, I'm just going to read you the description as well. So it's opulent, sumptuous, imperial. Palatine Cyprus could be compared to Palatine Cyprus. Chypre Palatin could be compared to brocades or to a rare for such as Sibylline fitted for a tsar. It is perfect for daily wear, sophisticated, warm, precious, but easy to discreet, of an unusual elegance. So,
yeah, I agree. It's very opulent, very elegant, very, very classy. It's like a proper Chypre. Old school Chypre with a modern touch, with this oriental beautiful base. For many people, this is a holy grail, Chypre oriental fragrance, and for me it is. I would like to have a backup bottle of this stuff because I love it so much. I would wear it even more often than now if I had a backup bottle. So I cherish this fragrance a lot. I wish that I used it more. I want to use it more, but I wish it last me my lifetime. Yeah, so
I mean, with your collection, it will last your lifetime, don't worry. And I think you don't really need a backup bottle.
Yeah, and now I have 100 milliliters of Diaghilev, and that one will last me definitely my lifetime. But What can I say about Diaghilev? A couple of words. I love it. I think it's a proper Chypre. It has a beautiful, bright, citrusy opening. Very bright, very uplifting also, yeah. And then it dries down to this a little bit floral, more heavier, very huge on the oak moss and leather, with this spiciness, yeah. Some also balsamic elements. Which one of them is more true Chypre for me? I think Diaghilev. But the opening and the heart of the composition of Chypre Palatin for me is also a true Chypre fragrance.
Yes.
Except for the base.
Yes.
But I love oriental fragrances a lot. It's like maybe my favorite style of fragrances. So I love dry down of Chypre Palatin.
Yes,
even after 18-20 hours, it smells amazing.
Yes, that explains why we both love this fragrance, because we do generally love oriental fragrances. So for us, it's like a perfect mix, like honestly. And that's why I prefer this one a little bit more to Diaghilev. Of course, I didn't wear it. Today was like the first time when I've worn it. But for now, I think I prefer Chypre Palatin over Diaghilev.
I think Diaghilev is more masculine than Chypre Palatin. Yeah?
It's still unisex, yes, but more masculine, I think, yeah.
Diaghilev is a little bit more animalic. Less sweet than Chypre Palatin.
I love a little bit of sweetness in my fragrances.
me too, but
I don't like when fragrances are cloying or sickeningly sweet, but I love some
this is not. this is not a secret sweet. The sweetness is here is perfect.
I agree.
The hype is real. yeah, the hype is real about this fragrance. The blending, presentation, the composition itself, everything is perfection for me.
I agree.
I will give this fragrance at least 10 out of 10.
12 out of 10.
yeah, 12 out of 10, definitely. And I have reviewed, I have watched a lot of reviews about this fragrance, and there are some of them truly exceptional. As for example, I really loved the review of a gentleman from Portugal. His channel is called Another Fragrance Reviewer. Amazing review. And he said that he couldn't do this review properly in any time, so he was afraid to do this review, as I am also. So, and I think he did probably the best review of this fragrance. I love it so much, and he explained this fragrance so perfectly, and he loves this also so much.
Yes, because
Another gentleman, which I also love his reviews, and he reviews this fragrance so perfectly from the channel Early Greek, and his face expressions were absolutely amazing. I love the reviews of that gentleman. And also another great review was from Rome 300, from his Smells Like Rome channel. He also did a great review. So it's at least sample worthy. For me, it's absolutely bottle worthy.
Absolutely.
Yeah. Great fragrance, great blending, great everything.
Yes, when you spray this fragrance, you just kind of, you don't want to review it anymore. You just want to sniff it and be silent.
I imagine wearing this fragrance in a party, in the movie which I watched a couple of weeks ago. It was called The Great Gatsby with Leonardo DiCaprio, and yeah, that type of occasion is perfectly matched with this composition. I think it's a very festive fragrance, and very elegant, very posh.
That could be worn every day also.
Yeah, it's kind of very special occasion fragrance, which I want to smell and wear every day of my life. In the morning, in the night, in the office, everywhere. At home, yeah. So if I had a bad day, then I came at home and I just smell it. And my mood is changing a lot. It's a scent of happiness and joy.
All right then, I think that's about everything that we wanted to share with you in today's video. I don't remember, did we mention that it lasts?
It lasts over 18 to 24 hours on my skin, depending on the weather condition. In summer heat, it lasts a little bit less, for about 18 hours, yeah. And the projection is very good. In this fragrance, I can smell it from my neck more than 10 to 12 hours. Yeah, so
same for
it's,
me.
It's amazing.
When I wear this fragrance, it lasts really an eternity, and it's just the projection is amazing. And with this fragrance, you notice actually what you wear when you wear it. It's amazing.
I don't know the year of production of my bottle, so
yeah, hard to tell.
Yeah, but this juice in this bottle is amazing.
All right, and now I think that's everything that we wanted to share with you in today's video. Thank you so much for watching us till the end. If you did enjoy this video, don't forget to subscribe to our channel, put the thumbs up to this video, and we wish you an amazing day. Goodbye.
Thank you, bye.